how are you going? This is Tash, the Starcross Stitcher, and that was a very excited introduction. How are you going? I'm really good. I've had a really great month, lots of stitching done. I have so much to show you guys. It's amazing. And I've got the Mirabilia retreat in like 10 days, and everything's amazing, and I'm excited. I tried to film this video. It's Wednesday, the 26th of April. I tried to film this video a few days ago, but I was really sick and I was coughing. I've had days off work for sickness, and that's probably why I've got so much stitching done. I'm disorganized. I have so much to show you. I'm really excited. I just got home from work. Oh, see this? This is my pussy hat. It's too big. I made it way too big because I'm a noob and I don't know how to make things. There's my pussy hat. It was literally the simplest thing ever to sew. I just like did that much ribbing and then that much stockinette and then ribbing at the other end and then folded it in half and sewed on the sides. And then when you put it on your head, it looks, the ears just happen because that's the shape it is. So I'm going to have to fold this up to make it wearable. I just decided to make it because winter's coming here. It's been like quite miserable. So it's going to start getting cold. And I wanted a hat. I wanted a pussy hat. And I found some wool and I decided to knit one and I did it. Yay! So I'm going to take it off now because you guys don't need to see that ugly thing. My hair's fading so much. It still looks pretty bright back there, but it's all fading at the roots. It's disgusting. Maybe I should leave it on because it looks so disgusting. How have you guys been? I'm sure I already asked you that. Okay, I'm going to talk about the stitching I've done. The last video I made was at the beginning of Jessie Miller. I look ridiculous. The last video I made was right at the beginning of Jessie Marie's stitch along. So I'm going to talk about what I actually did stitch, what I finished, because I have a few finishes, and then talk about, I don't know, other stuff that's going on. Oh, yeah, I've got quite a bit of haul, and it all came from my mum for free, so that's awesome. But let's go through the whips and finishes first. So the 15th said work on your oldest whip, which was Dream a Dream. And I also worked on this the next day for the letters J, M, D, and S. Dream a Dream starts with D. So 15th and 16th I worked on Dream a Dream, which is this one. And it's finished, as you can see. Isn't that lovely? I'm not going to read it to you because I'm lazy. But it's a very nice verse. It's so cute. I did it for my little nephew Ben. You can see I wrote his name at the end of the first, the end of the first verse, I read his name. I'm sure you can see through it and see how. The first thing I had to do when I picked this up was, see, I started this in 1992 when I was 9 years old. And the back is disgusting. And there were literally like carried threads, like threads carried from here over to the frog. And like from this line here down to this line. And it was terrible. Look at this butterfly. Like, it was so bad. And there were like stitches that weren't crossed and back stitch was like missing from around the butterfly, or not the butterfly, the robin and stuff. It was crazy. So the first thing I did was like tidy up a few things. It's really funny. I can see how much my stitching's changed in the years. Like my tension was very tight when I was younger. Oh, it was a mess. Anyway, so that was the first thing I did. And then I just had to do the last three verses, which I did. Please don't point out the counting errors if you notice. And how the verses aren't aligned. Don't notice that. It doesn't matter. Ben isn't going to mind. He's going to love this. So yeah, I'm really proud of that finish. I think it's very cute. I did change a few of the words for poetic reasons and some of the other words for, it was all like Jesus-y at the end. And I'm not religious, so I just changed it to shepherds. And it was, I'm happy with it. And the recipient is going to love it. And that's the important thing. So I'm really happy with that. That was my 25 year old whip. It's now finished. So this and Firefly Fairies were my two oldest whips and they're now done. And I feel kind of like I'm homeless or something. No, that's crazy. I just feel like it's a strange feeling to have your two oldest whips finished and done and gone. It's a strange feeling. Oh, by the way, about this. A lot of people have said they wanted it. I didn't realize so many people would want the Firefly Fairies chart. If you want this, go back to the last video and say you want it. I realised I didn't say in the last video when I'd say who won it, because I didn't realise it was going to be a competition. So go back to the last video and put your name down before the 15th of May, and I'll, like, draw the names out of a hat on the 15th of May. Okay, moving on. So that was the 15th and 16th. I worked on Dreamy Dream, and I finished it. The 17th was Enabled. Stitch on something you were enabled to start. And then I stitched on Red Skies at Night by Mirabilia. And I also stitched on it on the 18th for favourite colours, which was purple. So that's Red Skies at Night by Mirabilia. I showed you guys the finished model in a previous video. I've only got a photocopy here. Oh, I don't even have a photocopy here. Sorry. So all I did, on the 17th I did one green strand. Actually, it's on this side. The 17th I did one green strand, and on the 18th I did one purple strand. Yeah, I was, like, not well. I was starting to get sick. So that's all I did for this. Kind of sad, but oh well. Mirabilia Retreat's coming up, so I will be working on this at the Mirabilia Retreat. I also have a new start plan for the Mirabilia Retreat, which is the Bellas, the Bella ladies. Bella Rose, Bella Hydrangea, and Bella Butterfly and Bella Bee. I have them all kitted up. I've got the fabric, beads, water lilies, everything. So I probably will start them at the retreat. And also, there's an exclusive retreat design, and I've got the kit for that. I'll be receiving the kit for that at the retreat, so I might start that too. Just what I need, 3 Mirabilias on the go. But I did have 6 finishes this month. 7 if you count the hat. So maybe I at least have room in my list of whips. So the 19th was stitch on an animal. And the 20th was stitch on something pretty. And for both of these, I worked on the round robin that I'm on this month. And it was... this is Coral's round robin, and it is a little... It's called a blue tit. The design came from a magazine. I don't know which one, I'm sorry. But it's also part of a larger anchor design that's charted by Anchor. And it was originally charted for Anchor Threads, but Coral recharted it for DMC. And he is very pretty. I'm really happy with him. The fabric was this... It's very pretty. It's a very pale purpley colour. I'm not sure if you can pick up the colour on here. It's so soft. It was really actually kind of difficult to stitch with because it was so soft. I also found it really difficult to stitch because Coral stitches go like... I go bottom left to top right on the bottom. And she goes bottom left to top right on the top. So I had to turn it sideways to stitch. So I stitched the whole thing sideways, which was a little strange. And I also had to, like, go around, because the rest of the chart was already there, and backstitch, so I had to, like, fit my stitches under some of the backstitches that overlapped the sections. It was weird. But he turned out really sweet, and I'm happy with him. So I stitched on him for an animal on the 19th, and Miss Congeniality, something pretty, on the 20th. And I finished it. So that's the third finish. Then... stitch on something difficult. And I pulled this one out, not because it's difficult, but because it was so close to finished, and I was finding trouble motivating myself to work on it. So I thought this was a good opportunity to pull it out and make myself just finish it. And I did. This is, the Schwalm White Work by Deborah Love. I actually started it at a class with Deborah at Beating Around the Bush in 2014. Yeah, so it's all just surface stitches and pulled stitches. Oh, it's not really going to focus too well. Yeah, it looks much more difficult than it is, honestly. There's no cutting of fabric here. It's just simple stitches like lazy daisies and eyelets, satin stitch, buttonhole stitch, four-sided stitch. That's it, pretty much. Oh, and coral knots. Oh my gosh. Coral knots. So much coral knotting. Anyway, yeah. So that is a finish. And I think it's very pretty. I like it very much. And I'm glad I had to work on it. Because I'm so happy to have it done. Then for the 22nd, we had... The theme was close to 30. Stitch on something that's close to finished. So I pulled out Paddington Bear and I finished it. This is Paddington in Sydney. This is one of a series of four. I've also completed Paddington in London, New York, and Paris. And this is the last one, Sydney. And these four are going to be framed up and given to my nephew, Lachlan, who he reads the Paddington books and he really likes cities and landmarks, so he's going to like these. So I've now finished something for each of my three nieces and nephews. So the Firefly Fairies was for my niece Charlotte, Dream a Dream was for her twin brother Benjamin, and this is for their older brother Lachlan. So yay! It's been a great month. I mean, it's so satisfying finishing all these things that I've been working on for so long. I feel really good. I need to get these framed up. I have frames for them. I don't have frames for the other two. I'm hoping to find a frame for Dream a Dream, and I'm going to get Firefly Fairies professionally framed. I don't know when. At some time. So let's move on. Oh, the theme on the 23rd was 29. Stitch 29 stitches, 29 minutes, something like that. I decided to do 29 queen stitches on my Celtic sampler. And that is what 29 stitches looks like, just there. 29 queen stitches. This whole thing is solid queen stitches. So if that's 29, you can imagine how many stitches are in here. Like 400, maybe? I don't know. There's a lot. I think this one over here is also solid queen stitch. This one. I think this one is. Yeah. Ugh. I hate queen stitches. I hate them. I hate them. Someone commented on one of my last videos, or maybe on Instagram, that someone had done this and had calculated that there were over 1,000 queen stitches in this. Why did I choose this pattern? I didn't realize that it was like 3/4 solid queen stitch. I've always hated queen stitch. It's so much worse on this because they're so packed in, they're bumped up right next to each other, you've got to squish them in, and it's on 40 count, so they're very tiny. They're challenging. And they take a long time. Like, one queen stitch is not like one cross stitch, it's like 4 cross stitches. And it takes longer than 4 cross stitches. It's crazy. I think my ears look dumb, guys. I might never wear this because it kind of looks dumber than I wanted it to. Okay. Next. The 24th, bookish. So I was going to stitch on something related to a story, would have been Paddington. That was my plan. But it was finished. So I had a new start. And it is something I've been meaning to stitch for a while since I saw it. I finished it. This is Rose is a Rose. It's a freebie by La-di-da. The quote is from one of my favourite childhood books, which is The World is Round by Gertrude Stein. It's the most adorable, cute book. If you ever read it aloud. It's quite a hard book to read in some ways because there's like no punctuation. The sentences run on for pages and pages. The best way to read it is just read it aloud. Start at the beginning, just read the words. And you as you read it, you realize it's like a poem. It's very poetic language and it's so sweet. It's a really sweet story and it's just, I don't know, maybe you have to read it when you're a kid. But it just has such a weird place in my heart, such a cute place in my heart. There's this bit where Rose, she's climbing up at the mountain because the world's round and that kind of freaks her out. So she wants to go up a mountain and she takes her blue chair with her because blue's her favourite colour. And she stands on the chair to carve in the tree. Her name is Rose. She carves in the tree, Rose is a rose is a rose is a rose. And it like makes her not scared anymore. It's just really cute. Anyway, I changed all the colours on this except for the brown because I had the called for dark chocolate for the brown. The purple, I didn't have a good red or like pinky red. So I changed it to purple. And I thought that was okay because Rose's favourite colour is blue. And roses are meant to be pink. So blue and pink makes purple. Oh well, I don't know. It was the best I had. So I went with it and it doesn't look bad. The purple it was a limited edition gentle arts called Zinnia. The green was a limited edition gentle art called Gecko. The light pink in there was a Stitches and Spice cotton called Antique Rose. And this light yellowish colour is a Stitches and Spice cotton called Heritage. And the fabric is 40 count lambswool from xjudesign that I showed you guys a while ago. And I love this. I do not know how I'm going to finish it, but however I finish it, it's going to be adorbs, and I love it. So that's my finishes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Am I missing one? Oh, and the Firefly Fairies. That's 7 finishes for the month. Crazy, right? If you count the hat. Otherwise, it's just 6. So my whips at the moment are down to 22 whips, which is the lowest it's ever been. I've been thinking about Mania a lot. And I have I certainly have 31 things I want to start, or 15, or 4, or whatever. But I think I'm not going to do it because I'm going away for the retreat and I still want to cut down my total number of whips this year. Sorry, I'm not totally 100% well. Yeah, I want to cut down on the whips I have this year and I just don't want to have a bunch of extra starts. I'm not a person that it would stress me out, but I'd rather focus on what I have because I enjoyed achieving these finishes and I am sort of what people call a process stitcher. I do stitch for the enjoyment of stitching it, but I also would like to see progress. I like seeing progress as well. So that's where we're at. So for the 24th, I did this. I started this. On the 25th, the theme was birthday, have a new start, stitch on your most recent start or something with a birthday theme. So I stitched on this because I hadn't finished it yet, and I finished it on that day. Then I went ahead and finished this, which I had started somewhere earlier in the cell, and I finished it because it was my next most recent start. I'm really not happy with this. I don't know what I'm going to do about it. Okay, and then today is the 26th, and the theme for today is family. Today's the last day. And for family, I'm working on the sewing chest of Nantucket sister sailor Sarah Elliott, and it looks like this. Oh, isn't it cute? I bought the box and this Grimshaw ruler. It all came together. I got this to make for my mum. I bought it in 2010 for my mum's 50th birthday, and I started it then. She might get it by 2020 on her 60th, let's see, I don't know. So I started working on the actual box top, and this is how far I got. I'll do more on this tonight. I actually started this yesterday because I finished the rose and the hat early. I decided to go ahead and start on this. This isn't a new start, I have been working on this before. I stopped because I'll show you. I started working on the little whale needle case down there. And he's so cute. He says Crookjaw the whale. You can see how here I'd started. And, it actually doesn't look too bad on there. But in real life, you cannot read the words Crookjaw in the whale. The colour of the sable, the dark colour of the whale is sable. The two colours in the water, you can't tell them apart very well. And you can't read the writing Crookjaw against the sable. You just can't see it. So it took me a few years. I don't know why it took me so long, but I've actually chosen two other blues that I'm going to use for watercolour. Excuse me. This is what I was like the other day when I was trying to record. I was coughing like crazy. So yeah, I've chosen two other blues. It's going to look much better now. So I need to rip all of this out, but I didn't want to do that yesterday. I decided I'll just start on the box top, and there we go. This is obviously the sails of the ship. It's stitched on 36 count Mourning Dove linen from Lakeside Linens. And when it's done, it'll be really nice, but there's quite a lot of work in this. This is something that I said I want to touch this year, but not necessarily finish. I think I'll be really happy if I just finish the box top, because I don't love this project, I'll be honest, I don't love it at all, but I love my mum, so I think she'll like it. mean, I know she'll like it. She chose it. She told me to buy it for her. She was very happy when I did buy it for her, so I know she'll like it. Okay, I'll show you this thing. I bought a weird thing. Have you guys heard of diamond paintings? See this? It's a peacock. It's massive. Look at that. This is printed on a canvas. Can you see all these little squares with numbers on them? Like pixels, right? If you peel off this plastic cover, it's actually really sticky under there. And it comes with these circular plastic things that you're actually supposed to stick on. So there's a key up here. It tells you which color to use. They actually have corresponding DMC numbers, but not in this case. These come in DMC numbers, and the numbers will all be here on the key, and then you'll use the key so you know what color exactly to put on each little square. When it's finished, it's all sparkly because these little diamonds, you'll never be able to see properly, but they're all faceted, so they catch the light and look really sparkly. A lot of people have started talking about these and doing these. Some people have even sent away for blank gridded plastic canvases, and they've ordered the diamonds that they need because the diamonds correspond to DMC colours, and they've made a heaven and earth design, and they're going to do it as a diamond painting. So the size of the diamonds is fixed. It's fixed at 10 or 11 diamonds per inch. So if you do a heaven and earth design, it's going to be massive. Like, imagine doing your Hade on 11 count, 10 or 11 count Ada. It's going to be massive. So some people have got these canvases that are like this for their Hade. It's going to be amazing. I'm not going to dive down that rabbit hole just yet, but I thought a little one like this will be good enough to see if I enjoy it or not. I don't see myself getting into it enough to do a diamond painting, but I thought it would be fun to check out. It also comes with, this is like little glue. This is the pen. You stick the end of the pen in the glue. You put your diamonds on the tray. And then you use the pen to pick up the diamond and then stick it to the sticky paper. It's not paper, it's canvas. It's really thick. It's interesting. I don't know if I like it, but I'll update you when I start it. And I'm not in a hurry to start it either, so you might not get an update for a while. So, when I made my last video, I was just heading to my mum's house and I said we were going to kit up and a forest group. And we did. I've got a bunch of threads. My mum has huge stitching stash. When we lived in America, my mum went crazy. We used to go to Joanne's, she said, or we had a Total Crafts and a Michael's near us. We lived in DC, near DC. And she said she used to bring all of us four kids and she'd give us a list. We'd all be pulling threads off the shelf and going up to the counter one by one to check the threads through. Mum has this huge box like this full of DMC threads and there's like 10 of each colour. It's crazy. It's crazy. She has so much stuff. So she's got rolls of linen, like metres and metres on rolls. It's crazy. She has amazing stuff. This is like a natural colour, I guess. It's really nice. It's 35 count. I think it's a raw linen. This is what I'll be doing and a forest grew on. Look, it's big enough to have it cover the whole video. Mum's using a lighter colour, like just a regular cream colour, I think. But it's like a Italian linen. It's something very special. I don't know what's special about it. So Mum and I will both be starting that very soon. Mum hasn't stitched for a long time. She just pulled out some stitching this week and started it and posted it on Instagram. So I think she's enjoying stitching again. Another thing we found at my mum's house is actually the first cross stitch I ever did. And I'm excited to show you guys. The story is, I actually remember this. I was 6 years old and we lived in England at the time. And Mum was in bed stitching and I was with her because I was sick or something. And I said, Mum, I want to try stitching because I'd seen her stitching all the time. She had done a couple of alphabets. I know she did the Beatrix Potter alphabet, the Kate Greenaway alphabet. I know she had worked on a few samplers, and I said I want to try it anyway. So she went and got me some Aida, and she showed me how to thread a needle and gave me some colours, some scraps from her kit or whatever. And she said she came into my room the next day and I had done all of this. And she was just shocked. That's my first ever stitch. Isn't it cute? I think it's super cute. I can't believe I did it. I remember being like fascinated about how, yeah, terrible back. About how when you did a diagonal line, it would make the little V's like, they look like flying birds to me. Like flying birds. So I liked the V's. So I did a lot of diagonal lines in this. That's why I did the envelope shape. And then I did an ABC because I knew that Mum did samplers and they all had alphabets on them. So I had to put an alphabet on mine. Yeah, I just think it's really cute. It's kind of crappy, of course. It's a six-year-old's work. But yeah, Mum said I'm allowed to borrow this to show you guys in my video and then I have to give it back to her. So it doesn't get lost because she thinks I'm going to lose it. Yeah, it's so cute, right? I'm really proud of it. Yeah, so we looked through a bunch of Mum's stuff. Mum has doubles of lots of things, so she gave them to me. Shepherd's Bush needle rolls. Mum has stitched, I think, all of them. And I even stitched a few when we lived in America. These are really cute because they stitch up so quickly. These are all kits, by the way. They all come with beads and charms and lace, ribbon and silks and fabric. They stitch up really quickly. They often have specialty stitches in them. The bands are only about this wide, you know, maybe 2 inches. And they're only 4 inches long maybe. And then you just sew them up into a cylinder and put the ribbon around the top. They're so simple. They're really cute. I used to make one in a day when I was home for the holidays. I went to boarding school when we lived in America and I went home for the holidays. I love this one, Bumblebee. I might do this one in May. This might be my mania, do a tiny little shepherd's bush needle roll. Forget me not. Yeah, I like these, Americana. I think I've done this one. I'm pretty sure I've done this one. I remember it. She had two of these. It's sort of a needle roll. It says Shepherd's Purse. Needle roll? I don't know. I don't know what that is. It's like a fold-up thing. It doesn't come with the lining fabric, though. That's a shame. But yeah, silks, charms. And then she had two of these as well. It's a big one. What is it? Winter's Hearts. Winter Hearts. It's pretty, right? I like these. So a bunch of free stuff from Mum. She also had two of this pattern, which I really like. It's called Band of Many Colours. I think it's very pretty. It's by The Sampler House. The Sampler House. I don't know who that is. There you go. There's information if anyone wants to search for it. It's really pretty. I'd like to do that one day. My video is coming up to half an hour, so I might get cut off soon. But I'll start again because I have more to show you. Mum had two of these. This is one of the out-of-print prairie schoolers. It's on the cardstock paper. Village green. See the? I love the little chicken background on these roosters. Little baby chickies. So cute. Yeah. I don't even like this. I'm never going to stitch this. Don't like it. But she had two of them, so I thought, why not? This is one I almost ordered last week from the States. Just a sampler of stitches by Darlene Osteen. The needle's Prayse. There you go. It's a cute, quick one. I could do that pretty in like a day if I wanted to. Oh, it's all GMC. All right, I might do it one day because I like it. Yeah, so that's everything I got from Mum. All this free stuff. Love it. You can't complain about free stuff. What else? I have been looking through the sampler and antique needleworks that my grandma sent me. And I'm just going to show you some of my favourite things, okay? I'm not going to show you the whole lot because it's crazy. Issue 21. Check out that beautiful, beautiful Quaker sampler. It is called... Where is it? Quaker Medallion Sampler and Bellpull. Lovely. It's very pretty. Nice colours, right? I like that. I might do that one day. The other thing I marked in here What is... Oh, this is crazy, this one. This is insane. I would love, love, love to do this. Sorry. I would love to do this, but I think I would be crazy. I have too many whips. This is something that would take me years. It's called the Millennium Cutwork Sampler. I'll try and get it all in. There it is. Obviously, it was designed in the year 2000. Check out the detail on these mermaids. Like, amazing, right? Crazy. It's by... Who is it by? Sharon Cohen. And I've been looking at Sharon Cohen charts. I wanted to order a couple of needle lace charts like this. I'm actually doing a needle lace project. I have a whip. I'll show you. I'll show you because I have it handy. Oops. Oh my god. Don't worry. It's not a disaster. It's from this book, Cruel Twists by Hazel Blomkamp. This book has amazing stuff. Look how cute that is. Yeah. Oh, look at this. Like, amazing, right? But the needle lace project I'm doing is this one. Pretty, right? It's... this is all attached needle lace. It's not... the stuff in that white work sampler was all detached. All, you know, sewn onto the lattice work that, of fabric that you left there. But this is all done on a... So you do a satin stitch underneath, or a padding stitch underneath, and then a border, and you do your buttonhole lace on top of the border, on top of the padding. Sorry, got cut off. It's called Autumn Lace by Hazel Blomkamp from the book Cruel Twists. It's a great book, so many nice things. Good instructions, pretty pictures. Check that out, oh my gosh. This is all beads. Not all beads, it's a lot of beads. Crazy. Yeah. Didn't mean to show you that. Yeah, all I've done is like literally one little lace part in the middle. And it's messy, so I put it away. I'll pick it up one day. Issue 22. That white work one is a four part. It goes over four or five parts of the magazine. So it's in this one as well, but in this one, this is super cute, I think. Here it is. The Queen of the Sea sample. So cute. See, they should re-release this chart. People would buy it. It's so cute. there's a quote on it from Midsummer Night's Dream. And I would read it to you, but I'm worried about coughing more. The rude sea grew civil at her song, and certain stars shot madly from their spheres to hear the sea maid's music. Lovely. I want to do that. I want to do that. I want to do everything. I don't have enough time. I want to do everything. Volume 43, Summer 2006. This has this nice little white work thing that you could knock up quickly, I think. I've been reading the instructions on how to do this. It looks like it's kind of similar to hardanger. You cut some of the threads and then do woven bars around what's left. Then you just do sort of like a dove's eye in between whichever parts you want to make a picture of. So, yeah, cute. The other thing in here is, this is another thing that went over four issues and I'm missing one issue of it. But I know my mum has the DVD of all of the issues of Sampler and Antique Needlework. So if I start this, which I would love to, I will have all the parts. It is called the Old Aviary Sampler. I don't know how well you guys can see this. Look at that white work in there. Amazing. If you can't tell, I have a thing for white work. It's very pretty. I love this. There's a verse at the bottom. I'm not going to read it. Okay, I am. He who loves an old house never loves in vain. How can an old house used to sun and rain, to lilac and larkspur, and an elm above, ever fail to answer the heart that gives it love? Oh, I don't live in an old house. But I'd like that verse. It's very pretty, right, guys? I like this, so I would like to start that soon. Yeah, those are the highlights from the magazine. That's all I think that I have to show you. I'm exhausted. I made it through the video without the disgusting coughing fits that I had last time I tried to make it. I was coughing every three words. I was going to do a couple of tags. I was going to talk more about the retreat. I will talk a little bit. I'm really excited. I can't wait. I'm like going crazy. I can't wait. I've chosen who I want to sit with at the table. Hi Joe. Hi Claire. it's going to be great. I'm excited. Hi Taryn. I saw your comment. I haven't replied to comments because I'm terrible. Hi Taryn. I'll see you at the retreat. yeah, it's going to be awesome. I told you I'm kidding up the Bella Rose, Bella Hydrangea, Bella Butterfly, and Bella Bee to take with me. Have you seen the new mirror that came out? It's like a playing card with the Queen of Hearts and the Queen of Spades. Or clubs. I think it's spades. Yeah, I really like that. I'm losing my voice. I can't talk anymore. Guys, I'll make my next video after the mirror retreat. Wish me luck. I'm going to have fun. I hope you all have a great couple of stitchy weeks. I hope if you ever make a pussy hat, it turns out cuter than mine. Meow. Bye.